In this video, I'll be constructing moving averages and weighted moving averages for this data. Now, suppose we want to construct a four-period moving average. So I'm going to place my cursor in the fifth period here and type average here. Select the first four periods, enter, and drag that down all the way here. Suppose we want forecast for period 10 as well. That will be the forecast for period 10. And then forecast error is actual minus forecast. That's forecast error. And again, I'm going to drag that down. The absolute error is ABS in Excel. Then I'll select the forecast error. That will give me the absolute errors. And I can use that to find the MAD or MAE, which is going to be the average of these absolute errors. So similarly, for squared error, I'm going to square the errors. And then I'm going to take their average, which is going to be MSE. MSE is going to be the average of those errors. In fact, what I can do here is I can start the average from the top here so that I won't have to bother recalculating them for the subsequent calculations. So I'm going to drag that here for MSE as well. Now there is what we call RSME, which is root mean squared error, which is just the square root of MSE. So I can have that here. Square root of MSE is RSME there. Now for the absolute percent error, I'm going to need the absolute value of the forecast error divided by the actual value. Okay, and I'll multiply that by 100% because we're calculating absolute percent error here. So I'm going to drag down all the way down here, and it's going to be MAPE. And again, I'm going to drag this one to the right, and it's going to automatically calculate all the average for that column for me. So that is for four-period moving average. I'm going to copy all of this and paste over here for three-period moving average, and I can compare the values later. So for three-period moving average, I'm going to delete the forecast values here, and I'm going to be using the first three periods to forecast the fourth period. So I'm going to have my average here of the first three periods, forecasting the fourth period there. And I'll drag that all the way down here. So all of these have been calculated for me, but I don't have the third period. So I'm just going to highlight all of these, drag them up that way, and it will automatically calculate the values for me. I can check by double clicking here and see that it calculated the average of the squared errors for me. So looking at these two, you can see that the MAD for the four-period moving average is smaller than the MAD for the three-period moving average, and the MSE is also smaller for the four-period moving average than for the three-period moving average. So in this case, we will say using a four-period moving average is better than using a three-period moving average for this data. Now we can also do weighted moving average here. So I'm just going to copy this again here and paste down here. This time we want let's do a two-period weighted moving average, WMA, for weighted moving average. And we're going to need the weight. So let's say we have a weight of 0.36 for the least recent period, and then we have a weight of 1 minus that for the most recent period. So here I'm going to again delete the values here, and I'm going to start at the third period here since we're calculating a two-period weighted moving average. So I'm just going to add code them into it, equals 0.36 times 45 plus and then 0.64 times 51. Now, typically, we want the higher weight for the most recent period because we expect the behavior in the most recent period to reflect more in the current period. So we calculate that. I'm going to double click to copy that down. And for the errors, I'm just going to highlight all of these and drag up the formula here. And the errors have been computed for me. So it happens that these two period moving average error forecasts are not as good as the first two. Now I can display the graph for the 3-period moving averages by selecting the actual and the 3-period moving average forecasts and going to insert, select line here, and then select one of the options here. And you can see that the moving average forecasts are smoother than the actual sales in blue. And that's it. Thanks for watching.